Some have already played on the world's grandest soccer stage, while others must stake their claim today for a roster spot. One last chance to make a statement to U.S. manager Bruce Arena. It is a sold-out crowd here in Cary, North Carolina. This will be the site of pre-World Cup training for the national team tonight. It's the 17th meeting between the U.S. and Jamaica. Welcome in, everybody. I'm Glenn Davis. It is a night of importance for this Major League Soccer-based U.S. national team. A number of players on the fringe of making a World Cup roster. Tonight, the last opportunity to maybe prove your point to Bruce Arena. With that, I bring in my partner, Marcelo Balboa, the former U.S. national team captain. Who's got to perform tonight?
Two come to mind. Steve Ralston and Pat Noonan. Two players in particular that have to show well tonight. The fact that they're coming off an injury, they have to show manager Bruce Arena, one, that they're healthy, and two, they really need to create some havoc up and down the right side and the left side of the field tonight, getting some crosses offensively and being able to defend tonight.
Who can forget back in the 2002 World Cup when John O'Brien for the United States stuck this goal past Portugal? Is the Ajax star in the mix?
If he's healthy, 100% he's on the 23-man roster, but that's the question. Is he healthy? Fitness-wise is a big question. I think we'll see him tonight a little bit, and that's going to be a big test, just to see his fitness and to see how he handles this game tonight.
O'Brien now back with Chivas USA in Major League Soccer. We take a look at the U.S. lineup when we return. And welcome back to Cary, North Carolina. The United States national team supporters group, Sam's Army, out in force for this one tonight. And it's a night of honoring for Tony Meola as he makes his 100th appearance and becomes the first goalkeeper in USA history to earn that distinction. Here's the starting lineup for the U.S.
U.S. is coming out in a 4-4-2. Eddie Poe, Pablo Mastroianni. Pablo Mastroianni dropping out of the midfield, giving Ben Olsen a start right in the middle. That's going to be key up front. Taylor Twellman and Josh Wolf have to score some goals to solidify a spot tonight.
Jamaica starts with a familiar figure in goal, Donovan Ricketts.
Jamaica coming out in a 4-4-2. Davis and Stewart holding up the middle, very important. You got Hugh, number 17, out on the left, plays for the Kansas City Wizards. Very important, getting up down the wing. And Bennett and Ryan Johnson.
The U.S. and Jamaica for the 17th time will meet tonight, and it's a night of importance for both of these teams. Coming up next, the kickoff. A night of opportunities for players like Brian Ching, Taylor Twellman, Chris Albright. One good performance tonight could be the difference in earning a roster spot for the United States in this summer's World Cup. Welcome back to Cary, North Carolina. The conditions here absolutely gorgeous tonight. 67 degrees, the field in great condition. And that man there, Landon Donovan, expected to be a key part of tonight's match. The United States wearing white. And Jamaica will be in the goal. As we mentioned before, these teams have met before. The last time they met was in the Gold Cup last summer. And the United States got a 3-1 victory in the quarterfinals. And the U.S., you got to wonder what's going on through the minds of a number of these players tonight who are trying to earn a spot to go to the ultimate sporting event, the World Cup, this summer in Germany. U.S. dressing 18 players tonight, 6 substitutions allowed for both of these teams, and of course it is the last game that U.S. players will have before May 2nd when Bruce Arena will pick his 23-man squad that will go to Germany. So a quick look there at Tiafoe Bennett, who plays for the Atlanta Silverbacks in the USL. And it's game on here in Cary, North Carolina, the United States and Jamaica. And right over the top goes Jamaica to start this one off. And that was Bennett, dispossessed by Albright. Noonan, and he tried to bring in his New England Revolution teammate, Taylor Twellman. There is Bruce Arena, the manager of the United States, will lead them to the World Cup for the second consecutive time. And it's pretty clear to say that he is the most important head soccer coach in the history of the United States national team. Jamaica now. This is Campbell Rice. And Albright wins it. Solid tackle from him. As the U.S. trying to clear the area. Marcelo, and a soft back pass there. And off his line is Donovan Ricketts. So already the ugly side that we have seen on occasion from Jamaica rearing its head early.
Well, you can see right there, very lax, plays the ball back. Watching yesterday's training, the ball's very sticky, the ground's sticky. You see that ball right there? He hits it back, Davis, and it sticks, and Josh Wolf almost gets there.
Donovan was pressing Claude Davis. This is Garfield Reed on the turn, and a nice turn it is. And he held it too long. Ralston to Mastrolani. Donovan back to Ralston now. Boy, what an important game tonight for Steve Ralston. Here is Hadick, was dropped from the U.S. roster against Germany in Dortmund after injury. Jermaine Hugh, keep an eye on him. Had a great Gold Cup. We'd like to thank Budweiser and all of our U.S. soccer sponsors for allowing us to present this game without interruption. Wendell Dowswell is 11-3-4, actually his second stint in charge of Jamaica, and he's trying to change the entire attitude of the Jamaican national team, the federation, the professionalism of the players. More on that a little bit later. Hate it. Man. Eddie Pope. It's Ben Olsen to Donovan. Noonan. New England teammate, Steve Ralston. Olsen, Ralston into the box. Steve Ralston into the penalty area for the U.S. Olsen on the turn, left foot shot, took a deflection. What a turn from Ben Olsen at D.C. United.
That's a great work from Ralston. Keeping there, playing the 1-2, beating him. But look at the spin turn he makes. Great move by Olsen. Gets it into his left foot, looks up, takes a shot, deflects off a defender. But still, you like the quick move and the quick shot.
Olsen, Ralston, Noonan, all trying to make an impact here early and earn themselves a World Cup spot. Donovan to take the corner, wearing the captain's armband tonight. Towards the back post, Noonan is there, headed away by Jamaica. Ryan Johnson was in there. Noonan.
Get it over.
Albright is in there. Headed back in by Donovan and calmly headed back, showing nerves of steel, Claude Davis.
That's good communication, but you gotta like, so far they're organized. You like what Jamaica's doing?
Watch out here, chance for Jamaica. Miola off his line, Jamaica goes up. And what a finish by Tiafoe Bennett, the 19-year-old. A stunner here in Cary.
You talk about a release, and look at the run. Great run, perfect timing, in behind the ball, good touch. He just, look at that, beats Tony Miola. Bennett puts in the back of the net in the fourth minute, but it was all about the timing, and look at the reaction. They knew getting a quick goal. Now we'll see how the U.S. responds, but the timing of the ball and the run was bent was absolutely perfect.
Bennett picking up his fourth international goal for Jamaica on a night where Tony Miola is being honored.
Look at this, good touch to the outside. Tony tries to cut off the angle. Bennett does a great job of taking the ball to the outside and keeping it nice and low.
Let's go now to the third member of our broadcast team, Shelly Smith.
I had a chance to speak with Tony Miola before the game, and I watched the ceremony where he was honored for his 100th cap. He was very emotional. His wife was here on the field. You have to wonder how that has affected him, at least early in this game. His first cap came 18 years ago, and he said the biggest change that he's seen has been on the field. The level of talent and the depth of talent. He's impressed with this team. He thinks he might have a shot to make this World Cup sing. He said that Bruce Arena told him he has not decided yet. He'd like a shot to go again.
U.S. are in the corner, and get used to Shelly Smith. You're going to see a lot of her during the World Cup as she will be entrenched in the U.S. national team camp. Well, Jamaica obviously not honoring Tony Miola tonight. Donovan off the corner. It's a near post, and Eddie Pope from High Point, North Carolina, rising high to head over the top. Fire!
Just a great bar, but look at the timing of Eddie Pope getting up there. Beats Claude Davis right to the ball. Just gets underneath and puts it over the top. Already has two goals this year. He's a threat, no doubt, on set pieces.
Marcelo, this Jamaica team, we watched them train last night. They're young. Maybe they're not really that in awe of the situation here tonight. And a number of these guys are projected to be players in the 2010 World Cup.
But it's two different scenarios. Right now, Jamaica, this is a young team. We saw them train yesterday. Very big, very fast, and we've seen the explosiveness already of what they bring to the table. But there's no nerves. They're not fighting for a World Cup spot. Players on the United States are fighting for that World Cup spot. Sure, there's going to be some more nerves. Every touch is being evaluated by Bruce Arena. There is more pressure, and who can handle that pressure tonight? Who has a chance of making it to that World Cup roster?
Landon Donovan against Kari Stevenson. And it's Garfield Reed now for Jamaica. And handball. U.S. will get the free kick as it was handled by Jermaine Hugh. And Jermaine Hugh is the man who put Tiafoe Bennett in behind the U.S. defense for the 1-0 lead. Well, you wanted to see players respond. They have to respond now also, Marcelo being down a goal. Olsen. Haydick. Gets it over the target. It's Twelman over. And Twelman called for the foul. Taylor Twelman tonight certainly could tag a good performance here after scoring a number of goals.
Four goals, three assists in the last four games. No doubt about it. He's made a statement, but you know, he needs that exclamation point tonight. He needs to score a goal, gets another assist or two, but he needs something special tonight to say, you know what, Bruce Arena, this is what I've done. How do you keep me off that roster?
Here's Haydick. Pat Noonan. That's Steve Ralston. My apologies. Ralston. Olsen is trying to slip in. Ralston tried to bring him in. Ralston, Noonan, Chris Albright, all guys coming back off injury, and all guys trying real desperately to make the squad.
That's important tonight to have a good, solid game, good performance. Ralston coming off the quad that kept him out all year. This is his first game back. Question fitness. You know, New England's done a good job of getting him back fit, and he looks good so far. Albright, the same thing, coming off a knee injury to see how well he does that on the left-hand side. And for me, Noonan is the question mark. How well does he do? Because right now there's no depth on the right side of the field. You had Klein, you have Ralston, and Noonan could be a guy that fits in behind a Ralston on this team.
Claude Davis shaking up. And again, a reminder, this is an entirely MLS-based squad as we take a look at upcoming key dates for the U.S. national team. Well, May 2nd, the U.S. will announce their World Cup roster, 23 players. May 15th, the rosters have to be finalized. And June 9th, the World Cup begins. Germany and Costa Rica will kick it off. And for the U.S., it's June 12th against the Czech Republic, number two in the world. And that announcement will be live on May 2nd on SportsCenter. So, boy, I'll tell you what, that's going to be a very, very, very exciting day for U.S. soccer fans.
I'll be glued to the TV. I want to know who Bruce Arena picks.
Marcelo, I know you're going out on a limb these days. Who do you got picked in goal for the U.S. for that final roster?
Casey Keller, Marcus Hahnemann, and Tim Howard. I think those three guys. Casey Keller is a star, no doubt about it. Upcoming star, Tim Howard, and Marcus Hahnemann's had a great year over in England with Reading.
We'll also take a look at Marcelo's picks for the rest of the squad coming up. Ryan Johnson knocked it central. This is Garfield Reed now. And he's pressed by Ralston. He'll go back. As they swing on the right side to Omar Daly. Jamaica stunning the U.S. in the fourth minute. Tiafoe Bennett getting in behind the U.S. defense after a ball from Jermaine Hugh. Olsen went 90 minutes for DC United in their 2-0 victory this past weekend over Chivas USA. Here is Olsen. Here's Albright. Pablo Mastroianni tonight playing at the back. That versatility, Marcelo, obviously something that is great for Bruce Arena heading into a World Cup.
There's no doubt you want players that can play a few different positions, and I'll get into Pablo when we do the other parts of the World Cup roster.
Big tackle from Hadick on Garfield Lee.
Here comes Frankie Hedrick. Here comes Reese. I'm going to have to say that possibly could be a red card. Coming in 2 feet over the ball like that. I know it's a friendly, but the referee could easily thrown out a red card for that tackle.
George Gasso Flores, our referee tonight, as Donovan Ricketts drives this to the edge of the U.S. penalty area. Albright up in the air. Looks solid. In fact, scored in the air this past weekend in L.A.'s 1-1 draw against Chicago. Mastroianni. Daly, right to Tony Meola. Well, Tony Meola still believes that he could be a part of the final roster for the U.S., Marcelo.
You have to believe it. If you get invited into camp, at this stage of the game, you have to believe that you've got a shot. There's no doubt about it. Do I feel realistically? I think Tony's had a great career. I just feel that Marcus Hanneman has had a spectacular year over in England. And Tim Howard, you know, is the up and coming. You've got to give guys that are going to be the future of your team a chance. And Tim Howard, I believe, is the future, along with, I feel, Cousin from the Chivas.
And clearly, Meola has had an amazing career. Noonan, a huge tackle there. And you can hear it from Omar Daly on Pat Noonan.
Turn!
Olsen gets it into the penalty area, headed out, and it's handled there by Ryan Johnson, a member of Real Salt Lake. The U.S. will get the free kick. 13th minute, Jamaica, 4th minute goal, have the lead. Donovan Ricketts at 6'4", has 62 caps. For Jamaica, Donovan to take the set piece. Into the box it goes. Twellman was in there. And Ricketts is fouled.
Coming up right there. Look at Ricketts. Big, strong, gets up there. Taylor Twellman was already offside. The referee had his flag up.
Bennett again in there as Albright heads it back to safety to Tony Meola. U.S. lifetime 9-0-7 against Jamaica. And they've outscored him 28-9. Josh Wolf, 3 goals in 3 games. And he is available tonight. Again, their last meeting in the Gold Cup quarterfinals, a 3-1 victory. Beasley had 2 in that one. Wellman to Albright. Noonan tried to slip in Albright to Olsen. He's going to try it over the top. You can tell the minute he hit it. ESPN2's presentation of U.S. soccer is brought to you by Budweiser. Bright, crisp, clean, pure. This is Budweiser. This is beer. Panasonic, official sponsor of the U.S. men's national team. Panasonic, ideas for life. And the 2006 Sonata, a Hyundai like you've never seen before. It seems like Jamaica is doing a good job getting back behind the ball here tonight. Eddie Pope. Donovan the restart to Hadick, who quickly gets it to Ralston. Again towards Twellman. And right now the aerial game is being won at the back by Jamaica. I mentioned mentioned that Josh Wolf would get a game tonight. He is getting a game. He was in the starting lineup. Jamaica's goal, it was constructed by Jermaine Hugh out of midfield.
Well, and it was a great look. And if we stop right there, look at Frankie Hitt. Never looked once where Bennett was. He gets in behind with a great run, and now he's got it back in. He never took a look. He never looked over shoulder and see if anybody, plus communication from the right side. Nobody told the man was coming. Great ball, great run. Big mistake there.
He is a 19-year-old. Teofor Bennett, who plays for the Atlanta Silverbacks. And another chance offside flag up. But Pablo Mastroianni was out-dueled in the air by number 6, Ryan Johnson. Viola restarts it. Donovan shakes off a tackle, rode it beautifully to Noonan. And another strong, solid tackle. And a piece of skill there from number 16, Omar Daly. And the U.S. will earn the corner. The U.S. picking up their third corner of this game here in the 17th minute. Towards the near post. They'll get another. It's obvious the U.S. going at aerial during the run of play, Marcella, but big, strong, tall, good defenders in the air, Jamaica.
You can see where they're trying to pick out. They're trying to pick out the near post. Eddie Pope right there. You saw Noonan. You can see right in this spot is where they're trying to hit the ball.
Donovan again. They need the movement. Ricketts missed it. And we've seen him on occasion. Make big mistakes in goal, despite his obvious talent. And he completely missed that opportunity to punch that out. And Albright is fouled by Jamal Campbell-Rice of Rotherham in England. Chris Albright, another guy, Marcelo, who has missed some time due to injury. Where does he stand in the pecking order of potentially getting in this squad?
You know, he was invited into a lot of the camps until the injury last year. I felt he had a decent shot. You know, he can play more than one position. I think an injury early in January really hurt his chances of making the squad just because of the injury, not because of the way he's been playing. Takes too long. It took too long. Too many games he missed. Key games, be it the Poland game, the Germany game, too many games missed. I think that's why he's on the outside looking in.
Broken up again. Here's Donovan. They get it switched to Hayden. Noonan is slow to get up after that tackle. Ralston to Albright. And they'll swing it to Noonan here on the left side. Olsen. Eight players behind the ball for Jamaica now, and the U.S. will go back to Eddie Pope.
Yes.
Who's joining in, headed away by Garfield Reed.
And I'll say, this is very good for the U.S. right now. This is what most World Cup teams will do in a game. They will drop off all 11 into their own eight, into their own half, and they'll defend in that. So this is good preparation for the U.S.
Ralston, Olsen, Claude Davis broke it up. Well, Marcelo, I know you being a former defender with over 100 caps yourself, you got your ideas about who's going to make the final roster.
I did. I have 7. I got Bocanegra, Steve Cherundolo, Gibbs, Hayduk. I got Lewis, Onyewu, and Pope. I think 7 fills what you need in the back. And if you have a problem, you still have Pablo Mastroianni, who can slip into the back like you see tonight as an 8th defender.
And in the second half, we'll take a look at your potentials for midfield and also up front. Garfield Reed knocks us towards Campbell Rice, cleared by Pope. That's pretty ironic. You've got two guys in Ralston and Noonan, both maybe fighting for that same midfield spot as Jamaica now in the 21st minute. Omar Daly. Read that beautifully. But he gets it poked away, and A good ball there to switch things by Damian Stewart. Plays in England for Bradford City. So Jamaica is a mix of very young players, some lower division players from England, a couple MLS and USL guys.
Well, you know, it's discipline for Jamaica. As can they play like this for 90 minutes? First, get by the first 45, discipline, keep the U.S. in front. And so far, you know, they hit their one counterattack, and now they've been sitting back a little bit. The U.S., patient. They need to move the ball a little fast. They need to go forward a little faster. It's given Jamaica too much time to get back behind the ball. All 11 are getting behind the ball and setting up their defense.
We are in Cary, North Carolina. It's the United States against Jamaica, and U.S. players battling to impress Bruce Arena in this final exhibition before he picks the roster. And that header just off the mark by Josh Wolf. Let's go down to Shelley Smith.
Staying on the outside. He has had the worst luck of probably any player on this roster. In January, he tore a quad before even getting into a game. He was rehabbing the quad in Carson, California, where they were training. And then he was walking down the ramp after he was completely rehabbed, and he re-injured the quad. He's just had some really rotten luck.
Thanks, Shelley. And tell you what, Steve Ralston, a guy who scored a huge goal in a 2-0 victory over Mexico that put the U.S. in the World Cup finals. This is a guy who might not make a roster, who's fighting here at the end to try and get in.
Well, there we go. There we go back to the injury. I think Bruce Arena, manager Bruce Arena, and the coaching staff know what Ralston can do. They've seen him do it through qualifying. Now it's a matter of game fitness. Is he 100% from that quad? And that's what you're going to see tonight. You're going to see Ross getting up and down the wings. He needs to do what he used to do, getting down the wing, beating people, cutting inside, taking shots, and getting crosses off. They need to see him at 100%, so it's an easier choice to say yay or nay.
Yeah, and of course, Arena will have all the remaining games in April of Major League Soccer to assess this group of players, which is an MLS-based squad, totally MLS here tonight. No European players invited into this one. Nor would they have been. Ricketts off the goal kick for Jamaica. Haydick called for the foul. It's been all aerial for the U.S.
I mean, but that's a good example. Look at Frankie Haydick the first 23 minutes, how aggressive he's been tackling. He's a guy that's fighting for a starting 11 spot with Steve Cherundolo.
Albright clears it. Big tackle by Mastroianni to initiate, maybe a counterattack. U.S. have got to up the tempo here. It's Wolf. Albright lost it. And this is Jermaine Hugh. Jermaine Hugh. And the final ball. Goal kick, U.S. Tonight, the United States have a number of options on the bench. You see one John O'Brien there on the right-hand part of your screen. Who do you think will get a run here tonight, Marcelo? Pretty much everybody?
I think everybody's going to get a run. This is a last chance. You got Brian Ching, who has got 5 goals in 2 games with the Houston Dynamo. I think you're going to get everybody. John O'Brien, 15, 20 minutes, maybe 30 minutes you're going to see tonight. And I think that's what everybody wants to see tonight. Hopefully you'll see John O'Brien, and we'll see what where he's at and how much he can progress over the last few weeks.
6 substitutions, we remind you, allowed tonight. Yeah, we'd expect probably a number of them made at halftime. Albright to Noonan. And he just gets cracked. Jamal Campbell Rice. We start to Olsen, and it was a quick one left to the shot, and he ties it up. Ben Olsen, the quick restart caught Jamaica.
Talk about
about a heads-up play. Look at Landon Donovan. Quick restart. Jamaica's not even ready. Nobody in the box looks over. Ben Olsen keeps it low to the far post. Rickett doesn't do a good job. Ties up the U.S. But you like the quick restart. And you see the way the ball moved just a little bit on Ricketts. But you like the fact Landon Donovan caught everybody off guard. Olsen was smart. Asked for it. His first touch into space. Took a shot. Tied the game up in the 26th minute. 1-1.
So Ben Olsen, who has been a long-time focal point of DC United, tying things up to the United States. And the quick thinking of Landon Donovan leading to that one. I have to say Donovan Rickett should have done better with that.
Yeah, but much better. But you know what? You got to give Landon Donovan tremendous credit for the quick thinking and Ben Olsen putting himself in a position where he can go to goal, and now he's taking a shot from 11 yards out.
And Olsen gets a big tackle in on Jermaine Hugh. You definitely have to honor the speed of the Jamaicans. Leaning again, tackle. That time from behind again by Jamal Campbell-Rice. These two guys have a battle going on outside here.
Well, it's a good test. It's a good test for Noonan. You see how he can handle the getting hit like he's going to get hit in a World Cup game.
Barry Stevenson. And Ralston is going to concede the corner. Let's go down to Shelly Smith again.
I'm told that Bruce Arena, one of the last things he told his team on the way out was to play the ball quickly on restarts, which is exactly what they did. And with that assist, Landon Donovan becomes the top U.S. player in history with the number of assists.
And that would be 23, breaking a record. He was tied with Kobe Jones going into this game. So congratulations to Landon Donovan. Jamaica off the corner. Jermaine Hugh. Good clear, maybe a chance here for Jamaica. U.S. trying to clear the area. Mastroeni is claiming it, and Mastroeni will get it. The all-time assist leader now for the United States is Landon Donovan. After that quick thinking to Ben Olsen. Rickett towards the halfway line. There you see the names, Kobe Jones, Claudio Reyna. Handball. Eddie Pope will pick up a yellow card. Already looking to make a substitution. Claude Davis will come out. And Damar Stewart will come out.
Well, and Eddie Pope got a yellow card right there. The ball skipped, hit it down with his hands. The referee, intentional handball, gave him a yellow card.
You'll notice Jermaine Hugh will take all the free kicks generally for Jamaica, although Kari Stevenson is standing over this one as well. It's Hugh. Yeah, and that was a wicked dipping ball hit from Jermaine Hugh. A guy that was made to be a huge star in Jamaica has not quite lived up to that potential.
Look at this ball coming in. Look at the way it just dips at the end. A little high. I tell you what, pinpoint accuracy on the corner, just too high.
A good Gold Cup. In the Gold Cup, they played Mexico in front of 60,000 people at Reliance Stadium in Houston, and Jermaine Hugh had a number of sparkling moments in that game. Albright and Noonan having a hard time connecting here on the left side. Radio Shack presents MLS Soccer Saturday with a special doubleheader at 4 Eastern. Chris Rolfe and the Chicago Fire visit the Columbus Crew and their new acquisition, Eddie Gavin. And at 11 Eastern, the atmosphere should be electric. The Super Classico, MLS Cup champion LA, Landon Donovan take on Chivas USA. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. ESPN and ABC are the official broadcast partners of Major League Soccer and the 2006 FIFA World Cup presented in high definition. And that was a mouthful, but that's going to be a great game this weekend. Chivas USA and LA, and LA, Marcelo, struggle a little bit.
You know what? The rivalries are what everybody wants. Those are the games that are going to help MLS build to the next level. Chivas, LA, the Red Bulls, and DC United. Those are the kind of matchups you want to see.
Donovan brings this one in. Ricketts will gather that in. Pick that one out of the sky. Has U.S. gotten enough into the feet of Landon Donovan tonight?
I don't think they've gotten into the feet of too many. They just haven't found a rhythm yet. Towards the end, they're starting to. They need to knock around. Jamaica's doing a good job. They're sitting back. They need to be patient, and that's what they're doing now.
Is it over-anxiousness by some of the U.S. guys just based on the pressure of maybe this environment tonight and having a good game?
Sometimes you're in a situation like this where you try to do too much and you're not doing the simple things. But Jamaica's doing a good job. This is what's going to happen in the World Cup. Teams are going to drop off. You're going to have to learn to be patient, find the opening, get the ball. When you find the hole, hit it, get the cross off, or get the shot.
Jermaine Hugh. Albright stepped up. But Stevenson pushes it out wide here. Jamaica will play on June 3rd. Friendly against England. Right prior to the World Cup. Twelman to Josh Wolf. And good running by Donovan. Can he get there? Trying to burst through two Jamaicans. And to the rescue was Omar Daly. Hugh puts a nice ball into space. Campbell Rice against Albright. Campbell Rice turning the corner and blowing by Albright. A ball for the back post. U.S. have got to get it cleared. Here's Hugh. Stevenson blocked by Ralston. Wolf can't control it. Jamaica proving a formidable opponent tonight. And a reminder, they've never beat the U.S. in an international match. Garfield Reed. Pope is fouled. U.S. will get the restart.
This is a good look at Campbell coming in. Watch the quick feet, the step over. Albright turns his back. You're not supposed to turn your back. That's where he gets beat right there. Look at Campbell with the space. That's how he gets in behind Albright. What fabulous footwork getting in. Big mistake by Albright. Never turn your back. Always keep your eye on the ball. And when he turns his back, you see Campbell exposes that, takes him into the space and runs by him.
Here's Donovan. Speaking of trying to run by people. Shut down. And the tackle's flying ugly here. Something's got to be done. Omar Daly. Cracking Donovan, and he'll get a yellow. This is the two sides of Jamaica.
Well, and you can see Landon Donovan with his pace gets right there. Look at Daly, comes in, gets the ball, but after the ball, he takes him out at the ankle. That's all eliminated if he gives a yellow card earlier on Daly when he tackles Noonan.
Yeah, you think to yourself. You hate to even mention the word injury, but injury is going to alter a World Cup for a number of teams. And this is one thing that you would just hate to see somebody get injured in this thing, especially a man of Landon Donovan's capability and importance.
This is a great up. Look at this great look. You're going to see players making a run into this space right here. That's where the ball's going to be trying to pull in. Watching practice yesterday, there's a certain spot they try to hit with big guys like Eddie Pope trying to set a pick.
Right to Donovan Ricketts. Fifth minute. Jamaica started it off with Bennett in the fourth minute, shocking this crowd here in Cary, North Carolina, and then it was equalized in the 25th by Olsen on a quick restart from Landon Donovan. Doesn't pull out of that one. Crunching tackle with Kari Stevenson. Nobody shying away from tackles here tonight in this one. Daly. Towards the back post. And the goal kick will come to the U.S.
Well, you can't shy away right now. If you shy away from the tackle, if you go to a 50-50 ball half, let's take a look at the Panasonic game shot. Hugh with a great ball into Bennett. Bennett makes a good touch to the outside to beat Tony Mio in the fourth minute to put Jamaica up 1-0. Great heads up by Landon Donovan. Catches Ben Olsen all by himself. Ben Olsen takes a shot, puts it in the back of the net in the 26 minutes to tie the game up.
your Panasonic game shots.
But let me go back to 50-50 balls. If you go in without the intention of going in hard, that's when you get hurt. Players like you saw Pablo right there, Pablo didn't back out. You have to go in strong. You have to protect yourself. If you don't, that's when you get hurt. And this is not a time to start thinking about, oh, I don't want to get hurt. You got to go in full board.
Noonan saved it to Albright. U.S. have had a hard time here establishing possession, Marcella.
And you're right, it's been tough. Yeah, the U.S. has played okay. I don't think they're moving the ball fast enough forward. They're knocking it around. Jamaica also is doing a good job defensively, packing it in, covering side to side. And so in the U.S., on the other hand, they just have to be careful of the exposed and space behind the U.S. with Jamaica's great pace.
Good tackle by Albright. Wins it back for Jamaica. The team able to hold possession for extended periods of time here tonight so far. You and Pope will go back to Miola. For the first time in U.S. television history, all 64 games of the 2006 FIFA World Cup will be presented in high definition on ESPN, ESPN2, and ABC Sports. It all begins June 9th from Germany, the 2006 FIFA World Cup, presented by Adidas. And it is getting close.
Best time of the year. World Cup time.
We're looking forward to it. You're going to be over there right in the mix, covering the U.S. along with Dave O'Brien. Noonan gets up. Mastroianni cleared it. Awkward. Headed away by Hayden. Jermaine Hugh. Ralston knocking it forward. Josh Wolf trying to get turned. And that time, Damian Stewart to the rescue. Plays in England for Bradford City, and they get it switched on the right side. Moving. And to bring in Twellman. U.S. have not been able to get the ball to the feet of Taylor Twellman up front or Josh Wolf at all tonight.
They've been having a hard time in the midfield, finding that possession, knocking around, and finding that link, that last pass to the center forwards.
This time they get it to him. He brings in Noonan. Olsen. Hadick. Crossing opportunity. They lay it back. Donovan, can he get a shot off over the top? And some good work inside the penalty area leads to that chance from Landon Donovan.
That's a little better. They got it from one side of the field. Ben Olsen does a good job switching it. You see Ralston come inside. It's good movement. They're making runs off the ball. The ball comes in there. They lay it right off to Landon Donovan. He gets it to his left foot, gets it over the top. But that's better. They're moving. They're getting plays. Look at the ball in here. Quick touch. Landon gets a touch, gets underneath it. But that's better. They're patient from one side of the field to the right side of the field. Ralston makes a good run coming inside to open up the flank for Frankie Hadick to get down there and get a cross off.
Gary Stevenson now for Jamaica, headed away by Hayden. Hope to Ralston. Donovan trying to burst out of a central position in midfield. Donovan, good touch here to Twellman. He's got a little bit of time and space. To Twellman. Right foot shot is blocked. Can Ricketts get there? No. U.S. along the corner. In the 40th minute.
Well, there you go. Taylor Twellman, good example. He dropped all the way back into the midfield, get a ball, plays it in the landing, makes a run after the ball, gets a shot off. Now he's starting to get involved in the game a little more. Not in the position you want, but at least he's getting involved a little bit.
Donovan. again. The U.S. not getting much success in the air tonight against Jamaica so far.
It's got to be timing. Jamaica's got some big center backs, some midfielders. They've got big players in the back, so it's going to have to be timing, beating your guy to the ball.
Serena said about 3 to 5 places up for grabs. Here's Olsen. He's making a stake. We're trying to be one of those people who make this final World Cup roster, which will be announced on May 2nd. Ralston. Side flag is up. Two New England guys finally hooking up.
Comes inside, he hits it, and wow. That doesn't look offside to me at all. Looked pretty even.
It's all bright. What do we got? We got a free kick for Jamaica. Coming up at halftime, we'll have the Hyundai FIFA World Cup report, including a look at Major League Soccer's impact on the U.S. national team, a controversial decision regarding Germany's starting goalkeeper, and find out which big-name player from Mexico won't be suiting up at the World Cup. Plus all of our first half highlights, that's coming up at the half. Noonan. Wellman. Donovan is in an extended position. They bring him in, but Ricketts is there. But it looked promising.
It was good. Lay back. Landon makes a run out of the midfield. Ran into space. Wolf hits it just a little too hard. But the idea was good.
I expect things will maybe settle down a little bit more in the second half.
Well, you know, I think it's going to be the same thing. You're going to play. The U.S. are going to make some subs. More than likely, those players are also fighting to make this team. So it's going to be a little hectic.
Wellman needs people in front of the ball. He's going to get one with Wolf on his left. Ball from Dwellman. Garfield Reed now for Jamaica. And he gets it out on the right side to Campbell Rice. And broken up by Dwellman, bringing something different to the game there, working back.
Comes back. Good defensive play. The only thing I would say is he had an opportunity to play Wolf running down the left-hand side, and that's what I talk about, playing the simple ball, don't do too much.
Donovan breaking out. This could be promising. Needs some running, though. Wolf to his left. He's going to bring Wolf in. Wolf against Ricketts. Save Ricketts. Now gets it. And the offside flag is up. It won't count.
Let's take a look. Right, yep. Look at the ball. When the ball's played, you can see him right there, just about a step offside.
An issue of timing for Wolf, who's looking to...
And he knows it, too. He knows it. You can see it. That's tough, because you've got the hole. You can see the ball. You can see the player. All you need to do is stay right even with the guy. Those are tough plays.
I'm going to be interested to see if he's on your list, because his mobility and movement, despite the fact that he's not scoring a lot of goals lately, his mobility and movement is something that adds a lot.
You have to wait till the second half.
You heard that. Right side to Ralston, and he lost it. We'll see your picks for both midfield and up front. Here Steve Ralston has had. Jermaine Hugh. Eddie Pope. Pope Marcelo seems to really pick things up at the right time. Bruce Arena saying right now he's as fit as he's ever seen him, according to Arena, since 2002.
Had a chance to talk to him a little bit yesterday with Eddie Pope. He's got a sore back a little bit, but this is probably the healthiest he's been. He looks fit. You can see how well he's playing. He's scoring goals. This is the Eddie Pope that you need hitting his stride this time.
1 minute of stoppage time
in the first half. Of course, Eddie Pope has 77 caps. Donovan, the only ones behind Tony Meola here tonight. Meola earning his 100th cap in a long, illustrious career for the United States national team. Began in 1988. Here's Ralston. Opal play direct.
That's it.
Josh Wolf. Came from a wide position that time. Did Josh Wolf.
That's what I like about Josh Wolf. It's just the pace. He gets in behind the people. He's not getting the balls he need, but that's something special that he does. He gets little flicks, but it's his quickness and his ability to lay a ball off and score goals, which he hasn't done much this year with the national team, but he brings something special.
Ricketts. And doesn't make good contact. The energy has been here tonight. The passion has been here. The quality of soccer hasn't. Nonetheless, so much at stake. And that'll do it here in the first half. The United States, Eddie Pope tied 1-1. And Eddie Pope and the U.S. equal with Jamaica. And let's not forget, as a member of this MLS-based squad, Eddie Pope has benefited from the impact of Major League Soccer.
Certainly having a league makes a huge difference, especially for our country. We needed to have a league. If we didn't have a league, I don't think we would have done as well as we did in 2002. There were a lot of MLS guys on that field in those games.
And welcome back to Cary, North Carolina. The United States and Jamaica tied at one. Ben Olsen equalizing things up. With the World Cup beginning in less than 2 months, let's catch you up on the news of note with the Hyundai FIFA World Cup Report. Oliver Kahn will not start in the 2000 FIFA World Cup for Germany. Jens Lehmann will get the job for headman Jürgen Klinsmann. For the host nation, the man from Arsenal will be in goal for Germany. Cuauhtémoc Blanco has been left out of the Mexican provisional 26-man World Cup roster. Blanco, who is loved and hated by both the fans in Mexico, not going to the World Cup. For the first time since 1978, the World Cup will not have a United States referee. FIFA has gone from 36 referees down to 23. And welcome back, everybody, to Cary, North Carolina. Glenn Davis. There is no doubt about it that the United States national team has certainly benefited from the fact that Major League Soccer has been around. Players in roles of responsibility have led to the success of the United States national team.
The national team wouldn't be what it is today without MLS, and I don't think anyone would deny that. Going into a World Cup year and having another opportunity to move through the first round, and that's certainly our goal. And that's made possible by the quality of players that we've produced within our league.
Just being in a professional environment has helped me personally, and it's helped the other players as well. It's obviously been a stepping stone for those guys that have wanted to go to Europe, and they've gone there and they've done well. So I think the MLS has been a huge part of the success of American soccer.
It's helped us mature at a young age and able to play, with men. And compete not only in MLS but at the national team level. I think it's been a tremendous investment that has happened here in America.
And MLS was great for me. My 5 years in MLS were unbelievable, and I have no problem going back to MLS. One day when I feel like I've proved myself and done what I've done in Europe, and it really has been helpful to everyone. And we have a bunch of guys on the team from MLS. They're doing well. And, a few of us that have gone to Europe, played in MLS as well.
It took a while, but now, the league's getting more money, it's getting more attendance, it's getting a lot more things it didn't have, 10, 11 years ago, So I definitely am part of the league for what they've done so far, and I'm happy that people can come out of MLS and still make an impact in international football.
It's been a tremendous influence for soccer in general in America, where at a time when if you weren't a national team player, you were selling insurance because there was no place for you to play. Now you have guys that are breaking through the national team at 28. You had to break through the national team right out of college, and if you didn't, there was no future in it. So that side of it it's become more realistic. That a guy just doesn't step off his college team and have zero pro games and end up playing in a World Cup.
That's it for the Hyundai FIFA World Cup report. Our halftime score here from Cary, North Carolina. It's the United States 1, Jamaica 1. Ben Olsen for the U.S., Tia 4 Bennett for Jamaica. Marcelo rejoins me next with highlights coming up. And welcome back to Cary, North Carolina. Jamaica and the United States tied at 1. Glenn Davis and Marcelo Balboa. In a first half, Marcelo, that is this what you expected tonight?
Yeah, no doubt. This is what you expect. That a lot of nerves, players playing a little nervous, and it's going to take some time for them to get out of these nerves.
Fourth minute, Jamaica stunning the pro-U.S. crowd here in Cary.
And you see, we're going to break down this first play. There's Bennett right there. Look, he's in between players. Ben Olsen's right there trying to scream to Frankie Hayter to get him. Frankie's looking over his shoulder. And now look, he loses track. Bennett makes a great run in. Jermaine Hugh plays a good ball in there. One touch in the fourth minute puts Jamaica up 1-0. You can see right here, Campbell coming in. You can see how physical the game is right there. He comes in, takes Noonan on the same play. Landon Donovan, quick restart to Ben Olsen in the 26th minute. Ben gets it low, puts it by Ricketts, ties the game up in the 26th minute, 1-1.
And Jamaica caught napping there. When we come back, we'll get a visit with U.S. assistant Glenn Byernickel. Join our own Shelley Smith. The score, Jamaica 1, the U.S. 1. Back in a moment. North Carolina, Jamaica and the U.S. tied at 1, and as promised, we go to Shelley Smith with U.S. assistant coach Glenn Mooch Myernick.
Mooch, a big night for a lot of guys. What did you see in the first half?
Well, very simply, it was a very disappointing start for us. I was disappointed in our aggression from the kickoff. They lumped one into our half that we let bounce, and they put us on our heels, and it took us a while to get going, but we responded, we got a goal, and we were a little bit better in the last 20 minutes.
All right, so what should we look for in the second half?
Well, we're going to change the two forwards because, as you know, as we're moving into trying to finalize our roster, we want to give everybody an opportunity. So we're going to bring on Eddie Johnson and Brian Ching up front. John O'Brien's going to get in the game a little bit. We're going to swap Frankie Hayter and Chris Albright because both of them are natural right backs. We want to give Chris a chance at right back. So we're doing a little experimenting tonight.
All right. Thanks so much. Back to you.
All right. Thanks to Shelley and thanks to Glenn Mooch Myernick for his time as the U.S. now. Have switched their forwards out. Ricketts again. It's been adventures in goalkeeping tonight on occasion with Donovan Ricketts.
Shaky hands. Shaky hands. He had the first goal. All he had to do was push it to the side, and he slapped it into the goal. And even on the one that was offside, it hits off of the hand and went into the goal. So
there you go. Eddie Johnson in for his strike partner in Kansas City, Josh Wolf. And Brian Ching, who has 5 goals in 2 MLS games for Houston, in for Taylor Twellman. Now, this could be a good moment for these two strikers to shine because the two guys in the first half, and Twellman and Wolf, didn't get a lot of the ball.
Didn't get much service. Had to come back too deep into the midfield, and they're going through good moments. Eddie Johnson scores. Ching scores 5. I mean, you couldn't pick a better time to hit your streak for Brian Ching, and now he needs to translate from the MLS into international soccer. He needs to capitalize tonight on this opportunity.
We'd like to thank Sierra Mist and all of our U.S. soccer sponsors, and we'll just take a look at that as Jamaica nearly catching the U.S. on that attack. We'd like to thank Sierra Mist and all of our U.S. soccer sponsors for allowing us to present this game without interruption. Tony Miola off the goal kick for the U.S., remaining in. And again, it's history for Tony Miola tonight. What a night. And don't tell him it's honoring, even though it has been. He still believes he firmly has an opportunity to go to the World Cup in Germany. Can't count anybody out at this point. Eddie Pope to Chris Albright. Ralston. Austin and Noonan have really not been able to penetrate on the flanks.
They've created some good spaces. Ralston's come in and let Frankie Hayter get down the wing a few times, but you're right. They look healthy, they're just not involved in the game. You know, from their injuries, they look 100%, but they're not getting involved. They're not running by people, they're not being effective. But that goes to, it was such a slow start from the U.S.
Now, and you heard Glenn Mooch Myernick talk about the slow start. Pat Noonan of the New England Revolution out of Indiana University. And a number of players speaking of the pressure of tonight's game and this opportunity. to again make a statement to earn a roster spot. Mastroianni's got to get it cleared. Hayden came in. Eddie Johnson, U.S. might have some room to get moving here on the counterattack. Noonan. There's Ching. Ralston. Make that Olsen and loss of possession there. Ben Olsen has the lone U.S. goal in this one. Coming in the 25th minute to tie things up. Jamaica earns a free kick. Eddie Pope the culprit. The foul on Tiafoe Bennett, their goal scorer. 19 years of age. Seven players who played in Germany on this roster. And this one threw everybody dangerously. Jamaica get a corner. The start of the game wasn't too good for the U.S., and now the start of the second half a little bit shaky.
You make a few subs, and there's still the pressure. You can't avoid it. The pressure's going to be here for 90 minutes. It's who can handle it.
Jermaine Hugh off the corner for Jamaica. Headed over the top. Well, Tony Meola believes tonight he is here on merit. This isn't just about his 100th cap.
Yeah, I told Bruce, I had this discussion with him a while back. He said, I want to see you get 100, and I said, I'd love to get 100, but I need to earn it. I earned 99 caps in my career, and I want to earn the last one, if that's the last one, and I want to earn any gifts. I don't want any gifts.
Meola has participated in three World Cups, a starter in 90 and 94, and who will ever forget the performance in the year 2000 when he led the Kansas City Wizards to the MLS Cup title. One of the greatest in-season efforts in MLS ever from a goalkeeper.
No doubt. By far, if a goalkeeper's MVP of the league, that means he led them that year. He took Kansas City on their back. He put them on the back and took them all the way to a championship.
Jamaica get the throw. Steve Ralston. So dependable throughout his years in MLS.
The guy, I see him, Mike. I see him. He's up very up and right.
Jamaica will get the throw. Mastroianni did not play this past weekend after getting ejected against Houston on the opening weekend of MLS play. Here's Garfield Reed. Flipped it in over the top, Meola there. Hayden. Mastroianni to Albright.
Turn.
Here's Ralston. He's got a run from Eddie Johnson. To the feet of Eddie Johnson. And not allowed to turn. By Damian Stewart.
Well, and we're taking a look at Ralston. A few minutes ago, we saw him grab his left groin a little bit. He grabbed it again a few seconds later, so we're going to have to keep an eye on that to see what happened over there.
Albright. It's time to cross it. Good-looking ball! And the kind of ball that Brian Ching can feast on. But that one headed out by Jamaica. Big tackle from Hayden. He brings it back. Frankie Hayden. Taking anything for granted. Ching. Nice touch from Ching to Donovan. He's got to love having Landon Donovan out here. Recreating that duo that led San Jose to an MLS Cup. How much is it about having guys you're comfortable with around you in a game like this?
Well, it's about comfort, but also it doesn't matter if you know the players around you now. You're still trying to play well. You want to make this World Cup team. Does it help having the players you're used to playing? Yeah, it does. But it also, you need to knock around. You need to do the simple things. You need to get it. You need to pass your move. If you're an outside guy, beat a guy, cross the ball, defend well. It's the simple things you need to do.
Ralston.
And this is earlier we were talking about. He keeps grabbing his left. You see him right here. He lunges a little bit. And right there, you can see he's already hobbling. He puts his hand on his left groin. So right there is where he might have just stretched it out a little bit.
Yeah, you just saw him there. You just got to wonder, you know, how injured he is even coming into this game, trying to make this final World Cup roster team. Some of the intangibles that we might not know.
I can tell you now, he's not going to ask to be taken off. There's no way.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure these guys would play on one leg right now if they had to.
100%.
So much at stake to get to the ultimate sporting event in the world, the World Cup. Donovan swings it in. Albright, who's been an absolute terror in the air this past weekend, tormenting Chicago and scoring once.
That's that Galaxy connection like you saw this past weekend. Look at the ball coming in. Albright gets in there right down the middle. But Ricketts does a great job of getting there and just tipping it over the bar.
Donovan Ricketts comes up with a sparkling save. Donovan off the corner. Near post, nobody there. He's looked good in the air defensively as well tonight, Chris Albright. Well, for me, Steve Ralston, I think, is struggling injury-wise.
Yeah, I think you're going to see Dempsey here in about 5 minutes coming in because he seems to be grabbing.
Yeah. And he just motioned, and Clint Dempsey warming up on the sideline, so it'll be a straight New England swap. Yeah, boy, you got a really feel now for Steve Ralston.
What up, Wally?
You heard Glenn Myernick say, what's up, Wally? Donovan now to Dempsey. Yeah, let's see what Dempsey can bring. Olsen to Mastroianni. U.S. have made three changes, Bruce Arena. Eddie Pope laid it down. Albright. King, left-footed shot over the top. Albright trying to slip in Ching. Let's go down to Shelly Smith.
Brian Ching just took that shot. It's a big night for him. He's very much on the bubble. He knows it. He rooms with Landon Donovan on the road. And the last night, the two of them had dinner. Landon's been trying to pump him up, keep him encouraged. He had 5 goals in 2 games last week for Houston. But he knows he has to have a big impact in the game tonight.
Brian Ching, 5 goals, as Shelly mentioned. 4 in the opener in Houston in front of 26,000 fans. Well, the impact of scoring 5 goals over the first 2 games certainly brings more attention to you. Brian Ching from Hawaii. Olsen, Dempsey. Moves away from pressure nicely. Clint Dempsey. Had a run from Hadick, looked him off. And a bad ball. Jermaine Hugh of the Kansas City Wizards switching it. And a great touch there from Johnson. And he tries to get it on the return and won't. The goal kick. All right, Marcella, let's take a look at your midfield choices now.
There we go. DeMarcus Beasley, Bobby Convey, Dempsey, Landon Donovan, Pablo Mastroianni, who can slip into the back as a defender if needed, Pat Noonan, O'Brien if he's healthy, Steve Ralston is a question mark now that he's healthy, and Claudio Reyna. I would say Ralston, if he's healthy, is there.
You know, Marcella, I noticed you're very top-heavy in midfield here with 9 players.
You know, I like creativity. I like. I want to see players go forward. That's why I like Dempsey. I think Dempsey, the way he's played, he thinks out of the box of like a non-American. He gets the ball, he dribbles, he does all the things that you don't see too many American players do.
It certainly brings a great attitude of not fearing anybody, Clint Dempsey. Question, concerned about the frailty maybe or the tendency towards injury of guys like Reyna, Mastroianni, and also John O'Brien?
I think you always have to be worried, not of those three guys, just of players getting injured, and it's going to be interesting. If you see, and you can see John O'Brien warming up, probably getting ready to go into the game soon, but you know, you're going to have injuries, and that's why you have alternate to come in, and that's part of the game. You know, you can't think about injury. I definitely think if somebody gets hurt, the alternates that are right there are very good players.
Here's Pat Noonan. Jamaica now. Jason Morrison to Jermaine Hugh. Ryan Johnson. Only 21 years of age, blocked by Eddie Pope, but he concedes a corner. Johnson has had a couple of good moments. He's a member of Real Salt Lake against the U.S. tonight.
He's young. He's been going at his teammate all night. Real Salt Lake teammates going at each other, Eddie Pope and Ryan Johnson. And you like it. They know each other, but the fact that, like I said, this is a young Jamaican team who is getting ready. I think, like the coach said, this game is a preparation for the England game.
And then long-term, for the 2010 World Cup. But Jamaica's going to make a change, and an interesting one. Number seven, Jason Morrison. Coming on is Dane Richards. Played for Clemson. And also San Jacinto Junior College in Houston, Texas. And he has lightning speed. Mastroianni will clear for the U.S. So Richards in, Morrison out. The U.S. will get the goal kick. So Ralston, it has been reported, that's the reason why he came out. 61st minute, we're tied at one. And more changes. Again, each team allowed six changes tonight. Jamal Campbell-Rice coming off. Coming on, Fabian Dawkins, number 9. 15th cap for Dawkins. Here's Noonan. Just can't turn the corner on this Jamaican back line. And they go over the top. A wonderful control from Eddie Pope and a good ball to Dempsey. Dempsey with a good touch here against Garfield Reed. And Reed showing that recoverability with a big tackle for Jamaica.
But what a great touch. Into space, Dempsey lets it roll past his chest, runs down the wing. Great job by Reed. But he doesn't think about dropping it and going back. His first thought, Dempsey, let's go forward, let's go forward.
Jamaica substitution in 64th minute.
Newton Sterling in. And Jamaica's goal scorer, 19-year-old Kiafor Bennett off. But a memorable night for the 19-year-old. Johnson back to Albright. Ricketts will let that one go for a goal kick. Yeah, the U.S. will spend in May their pre-World Cup camp right here in Cary, North Carolina. So this is a place that's very familiar to them. They're very comfortable with being here, and this will be their base before heading over to Germany and then establishing their base in Hamburg for the World Cup. And the community here in Cary, North Carolina, just been so supportive of the U.S. national team being here.
Fabulous place. I've never been here. This is my first time, but what a great place. The fact that this little stadium, the field behind where the U.S. are going to train, like carpet, absolutely phenomenal. I'll tell you what, you put a few more stands here with the turnout you got today, you got to consider MLS in this part of the wood. You know what I'm saying?
There's been thought about that and thought about a USL team coming here as well in the future. Dempsey chests it down, tried to get Eddie Johnson, and Richards wins it. And Wisely goes back to Donovan Ricketts. Damian Stewart, knocking this one forward, plays at Bradford City in England. Dempsey, and look at him get out of that space. Good ball from Dempsey to Eddie Johnson. Eddie Johnson. And broken up by Stevenson. Dempsey's added a little bit of confidence here.
Confidence, some good skill down the right side. Eddie Johnson, you can see he needs to get back into form, but you can see just a little bit of glimpse of what he can do. The quick cut there, his pace, and that's why I feel he's almost a lock.
Noonan. Bad ball from Mastroianni. Jermaine Hewen, this is a guy who can create. The Dane Richards, who's got pace against Albright. Slips it, goes down, wanted a free kick, won't get it. Here's Dempsey now. To Olsen. Has his head up, swings it on the left side to Noonan. Haydick is making the overlapping run. Can he be brought in by Ching? Nearly. And a saving tackle. To Haydick. Ching getting in the box. Haydick brought down. So a dangerous free kick for the United States here in the 65th minute. Brought about by that move forward from Frankie Haydick.
You know, and he wants to set it up to his dominant foot. He fakes a left-footed cross, cuts it to his right, and smart. He sees a guy come, uses his hands, lets himself fall, and gets a free kick.
Donovan taking all the set pieces tonight. Six U.S. players in the box. In front of Jamaica's Donovan Ricketts. Puts it in there, both Chin was there. And so was Damian Stewart. The U.S. will get a corner. And there's this ex-San Jose link up there between Donovan and Ching. Seventh U.S. corner. Donovan to take it right in front of Sam's on it. Swings it over again. Getting up is Albright. And Olsen, good ball back to Haydick. Mastroianni. Ching will chest it down. Couldn't get turned. And Jamaica now running. Omar Daly. It's brought down top of the box, won't get a call. He was definitely tormenting Pablo Mastroianni, who tells him to get up. And now, it may be Daly injured, clutching his left ankle. And this is a sub a lot of fans, and certainly the U.S. staff has been waiting for. John O'Brien, looking to come in here. Pat Noonan's day is over.
Taking their fourth change, USA substitution in the 67th minute. Leading in number
John O'Brien, who has played limited since such an impressive World Cup in 2002 for the United States, makes his way back into the lineup here tonight. After 10 years at Ajax, recently signing for Chivas USA, there's nothing but glowing commentary about what he can bring to this U.S. national team in the World Cup, if fit, if healthy.
When he's 100% healthy, and yes, I would agree, he brings things to the table, that good left foot, passing, good tackling. He has the ability to play in that midfield alongside Claudio and Claudio Reyna.
And here's what Landon Donovan had to say about John O'Brien.
I personally think John O'Brien is probably the best soccer player we have in this country. And a lot of people don't know that because they haven't seen enough of him. The problem is he's not always fit. He just has bad luck.
Well, what do you do, Marcelo, if he's 85% fit? Is that something where you say, do you put him on the team? Because we remember 98, injured players were brought with a U.S. national team.
I'm going to go with it. If he's 80% fit, he's on your 23-man roster. He is not on your starting 11. You need to be, I'd say, 99% to play, 100% to be ready to play in a World Cup game. You can't be 80 because that means you're still thinking about an injury. He needs to be 100%. If he's 100%, then he'll be a starter. But here it is. He has limited time to get back into fitness, to get his touch back in, and that's, I think, the question mark right now.
Race against time for John O'Brien. But what a brilliant soccer mind, a great possession player, and kind of the X factor, because people have lost a little bit of contact with him because he's been in Europe so long after that sparkling performance in 2002. And boy, some major achievements at Ajax in Holland under Ronald Koeman. Headed away by Pope. Boy, his career as of late has been defined by injury.
You know what? But for me, the smartest thing O'Brien did was sign it with Chivas USA. He's got a staff now. He can work at Home Depot. He's got Bruce Arena that can watch him from the next three or four games to see how he progresses. They can monitor what they do. He will be watched closely by the U.S. staff, by the trainers.
Donovan has got some space on the left side. He's got Eddie Johnson top of the box. It's Donovan. Shot from Johnson. Save Ricketts. Yeah, and you might have thought that attack was going to deserve a better ending.
Let's go, U.S.!
It looked like Landon was setting up for the right-footed shot. Eddie Johnson places himself right there. Finally, Landon says he's got two or three guys, lays it off. Eddie Johnson tops it.
John O'Brien did play a significant time for the U.S. in the Gold Cup title-winning run by the U.S. this past summer. But other than that, it's been pretty dry. Limited games, both for club and country. Dempsey. King is found by Damian Stewart. Is he coming too deep, Brian Ching?
I think both forwards have come deep because they haven't been able to get the service up high, so they've dropped into the midfield to receive the ball, to at least get him into the flow of the game a little bit.
71st minute, Jamaica's going to make two changes. Kari Stevenson goes out. Also number 6, Ryan Johnson.
Ryan Johnson.
Jermaine Johnson on. Neil Thompson on. Donovan towards the back post, and again Ricketts. But for a guy who's 6'4", tonight he has struggled in the air.
He struggled in the air, he struggled on the ground. The ball that Olsen shoots, he slaps it. I mean, it just doesn't seem to have the hands tonight.
13 shutouts for Bradford City. Donovan drives it towards the near post, and it's speared out by Omar Daly, who's been pretty impressive for Jamaica. Second minute, the U.S. and Jamaica tied at 1. Donovan. Dane Richards now for Jamaica. Nice takeover there. Richards making a run on the left side. Johnson switching it to Dawkins. Dempsey against Garfield Reed. Here's Donovan. He's got some space now. He's got a run from Ching on the right. He's got Eddie Johnson. Garfield Reed with a saving tackle for Jamaica. Johnson been in a nice little curling run there, and Donovan found him.
Good run, but Reed read it really well. Came inside, threw the old hook tackle with the left foot, and anticipated the play.
But the U.S. a little more success now on the ground.
straight leg!
Straight leg by Dane Richards on Chris Albright. Referee Jose Gasso Flores has officially let the two teams play tonight. 1-2. And again, the tackle's coming reckless now, and it's about time he brings the card out, and he will. The Barfield lead.
See the defending, but this is dangerous. Look at this tackle in front of him, clips him, a yellow card. No need for a tackle like that. It's a friendly game. It's just no need for a tackle like that.
Let's just take out the fact that obviously this is endangerment to players, but this has been historically a problem for Jamaica. Ill-timed tackles, bad times in games.
They lose concentration towards the end of the game. They lose focus. You need to stay focused. Jamaica has a very good young squad out here. They need to learn from this kind of game.
Donovan. Goes towards the near post. Albright! Oh, what a save, Ricketts! He robbed Albright. That was ticketed for the back post and the side netting. Albright is robbed.
Great ball in by Landon Donovan.
And in again, Ricketts. And completely misses that one again. Another corner, the 10th for the United States. Jonathan Ricketts, the 6'4" guy, has not commanded his penalty area that well tonight. Johnson. O'Brien with the back ball to Donovan. Whips it in again.
This is early on the opportunity. Lander gets it in. Here comes Chris Albright. Gets it down low. Ricketts makes a fabulous save, diving down low, getting down there. But you can see his face. He's like, what do I have to do to buy a goal tonight?
And as good as Ricketts has been on the ground on that play, he has been shaky in the air.
That was perfect, though. He didn't have to hold it. All he had to do was slap it away. When he's had to actually catch it or do something, he's dropped almost every ball. There, he didn't have to catch it. All he had to do was slap it out for a corner, and he did.
John O'Brien, with a good touch to Olsen, gets it back. O'Brien, look at that one-touch ball from O'Brien to Haydick. He whips it, and Ching is in there. Damian Stewart got a head on. Here's Dempsey now. What can he do? This one. Nice to pull it back. And the goal kick to Jamaica. ESPN2's presentation of U.S. Soccer is brought to you by Icy Cold Lemon Lime Sierra Mist. It's that refreshing. Budweiser, bright, crisp, clean, pure. This is Budweiser. This is beer. And Panasonic, official sponsor of the U.S. men's national team. Panasonic, ideas for life. And the U.S. working on ideas of their own. Trying to carve out a game-winning goal here against Jamaica. 78th minute. Davis, Marcelo Balboa, and the third member of our broadcast team down on the sideline, Shelly Smith. Look at that ball here into the space. Johnson get there? No. Ricketts does. Jonathan Ricketts certainly has been entertaining tonight. Let's just put it that way. Maybe not by design.
That was good with his feet. He came out, he anticipated, he knocked the ball out.
Will quickly become a bigger crowd favorite if he drops the ball and the U.S. finish off a second. Dempsey. Donovan. U.S. seem to have settled down a bit more here, Marcelo, although the pace of this continues to be rapid. Don O'Brien has delivered some beautiful passes here.
They have. The U.S. has gotten more into a rhythm, and Jamaica has lost discipline. They've started tackling people in the wrong places. Foul.
And the tips is broke down. That's got to be a free kick. And the U.S. will get one. What an idea from Clint Dempsey in the corner.
There's something special about this thing. Look at this. He doesn't think. He sees him coming. He sees two. Look at the heel. He tries to beat around him. There comes Stewart having to foul him. There's something special about Dempsey.
He's an entertainer. There's no doubt about it. So will this immense pressure pay off here for the U.S.? The back post. Albert again. Olsen over the top. He's trying to line it up. Take a look at the goals on our Panasonic game shots.
The fourth minute, ball in by Hugh. Bennett runs in behind Frankie Haddock. One touch, puts it past Tony Mill in the fourth minute to put Jamaica up 1-0. Landon Donovan, a quick restart, catches everybody asleep. There's Ben Olsen, puts it away in the 26th minute to tie the game up.
That's it, 1-1, 80th minute. Final opportunity for U.S. players wearing the U.S. national team to make their case for inclusion in the 23-man roster. O'Brien is fouled. And the second half sub, Fabian Dawkins. Nicely was Jermaine Johnson. Here comes Jamaica now with five in this attack. Jermaine Hughes. That footed shot took a deflection. Miola will handle it. All right, Marcelo, let's go now with the forwards and your picks for the final roster.
I think the obvious, the most consistent player on the U.S. national team, Brian McBride, Eddie Johnson, Taylor Twillman and Josh Wolf. Any kind of injury to those players right there, Brian Ching's right on the doorstep.
Here comes Chris Albright. Dempsey. They cut it into the box, headed out. Again by Damian Stewart, who's put his head to a number of balls tonight. Free kick, Jamaica. Jonathan Ricketts has been clutching his right hamstring. And Jamaica has used all their subs. Now Donovan decides to go down. So Ricketts may have hurt his hamstring. Wendell Downswell has used all his substitutions. Let's go to the sideline now with Shelly Smith.
Watching Tony Meola, it takes you back, and it must take Bruce Arena back a long, long time ago. He first met him when Tony was a freshman. Actually, Bruce was going to recruit Tony, John Harkes, and John Harkes said, you've got to see this freshman goalie. So this is back when they were in high school. Both those guys end up going to UVA, where Bruce was the coach, and the rest is history.
Thanks, Shelly, and that both those guys coming out of soccer-rich Kearney, New Jersey. Ricketts remains down. There is John Harkes in attendance tonight here. Ricketts is up. Yeah, U.S. better performance here in the second half, obviously? And
you know, it was a shaky start, but after about 15 minutes to settle down, they started getting some pressure down. Jamaica started committing some silly fouls, giving the U.S. opportunities for set pieces and getting into dangerous position, but much better since Dempsey's come on and they've been able to flow. The two center forwards have created some more movement. So, yeah, it's been a little better the second half.
Eddie Johnson and John O'Brien have added a lot. O'Brien has settled things down just like that with simplicity. He didn't put enough weight on that one, though. It's going to lead to a counterattack for Jamaica. Short out! So a giveaway in midfield led to a dangerous chance for Jamaica.
And there we go. He hasn't played in a while. His touch is off. He gets a ball in there. But you can see him coming in right here. He's setting him up, setting him up. Tries to get a quick right-footed shot off, puts it right by the post. And, it was better. But it came off a mistake from the U.S. But I like the way Dawkins grabbed the ball, though. Dawkins got it and went right at him.
O'Brien has looked very good on the ball so far up until that point. Eddie Pope trying to go over the top. Garfield Reed has gone the whole 90 minutes here on the left side for Jamaica. Nice header from Mascherini. Good composure there. Olsen. It's fouled, but keeps it alive. Here's Brian Ching to Donovan. In the box, Ching trying to get ahead on it. Jermaine Hugh now. Fifth minute. Hurtick and Albright switched here in the second half. They put Albright on his more comfortable right. Sort of sharing. Dempsey, what a strength to keep that vicious tackle from affecting him. What power. Eddie Johnson. O'Brien to Olsen.
Well, you can.
Johnson back to Donovan. They swing it on the right. They've got Albright creeping in. Crossing opportunity here. Just put too much power on. But a good move by the U.S.
No doubt, but Albright's done a great job of getting up the right side of the field, getting involved. He's been good on set pieces. Even right there, he gets down the wing, gets a cross off a little too far. He's been a little more active than Frankie has.
He's been dangerous in the air as well. Now we can attest to that because we were in L.A. this past weekend. Hit the crossbar off the head and also scored off a corner. Mascherini now, his first time running it forward to Donovan. Mascherini has joined in the attack. Mascherini trying to get on the end of this. And cleared at the moment of truth by DeMar Stewart. So Mascherini's first foray forward was dangerous. O'Brien. To entering the 88th minute now. U.S. concede a free kick to Jamaica. Eddie Pope of Real Salt Lake. Couple goals in recent games for the U.S., both against Norway and Guatemala.
guys out. But you like the confidence.
I do. With this new ball, the Nike ass out the way, it knuckles the way it moves, why not?
Ben Olsen now for the U.S. Jamaica's put a pretty high lineup here if U.S. can get somebody in behind. And they go to Haydick. Could be threatening here, can't get the cross in. Not been able to penetrate, it seems, out wide tonight, Marcelo. Johnson slipped.
I tell you what, Jamaica's done a good job. They've lost complete control of the midfield over the last 15 minutes. The U.S. did a good job of getting to the outsides, moving here, moving the ball around. They haven't been able to capitalize on a few plays, but they've definitely started controlling the midfield finally.
Another Jamaican player down. Well, tonight, Sierra missed man of the match. Is Ben Olsen not only a goal, Marcelo, but contributing so much more?
You know, he was all over the place the first half. He got the goal. Even the second half, he's done a good job of sitting in the middle with O'Brien and just playing simple, not getting out of the box, playing simple, not getting it moving, holding up the middle in front of Pablo and Eddie Pope.
Earning his 33rd cap tonight, his sixth goal at the international level. And of course, such a focal point for DC United. Come back from severe injuries. Jamaican player being stretchered off. Newton Sterling, only his second cap. 4 minutes of stoppage time has been added. Donovan, broken up again by Damian Stewart for Jamaica.
Other way, other way!
Johnson gets turned. Tried to bring in Haydick, but it was behind him. Frankie Haydick. Mastroianni now bringing it forward to O'Brien. Tried to slip in Haydick. Jermaine Hugh now for Jamaica. This is what it's pretty much been. Jamaica just playing direct.
Yeah, especially now that they're man down with Sterling being out over here. They've got to play smart. Drop everybody back, put one center forward. Make sure you clear the ball.
And a late tackle there from Damian Stewart on Brian Ching. Well after the whistle.